thank you very much, and good afternoon to everybody. If you do not know where is Nepal, we are between must discuss two countries in between China and India. So, and I'll try to discuss maternal health is a most difficult thing to improve. Maternal deaths are most difficult to reduce, number one. Number two, what happened before 2000, what happened after 2000, and why the maternal health improved. So in this perspective, I'll try to present my this presentation. So if we go for the development cooperation, it started in 1994, formal cooperation started in 1994 with USAID in malaria control. But before that also, maybe the development cooperation in health started with the British India, because the only embassy in Nepal, we were closed country before 1950, and only embassy used to be in Kathmandu, as British embassy only. So there used to be health services in Nepal before 1950. So some sort of cooperation was there, but we don't find any documents before 1950. So we consider this as a milestone. And after the USAID, there were a lot of multilateral, bilateral, UN agency, faith-based organization, private foundations, NGOs, and personal donors. Many, many personal donors have put money in the health sector of Nepal. We adopted vertical health project approach. Maybe 25 smallpox, TB, leprosy, FPMC, so many projects. There used to be a lot of projects. If you go over district, 15 projects. And a lot, there was a lot of confusion, who is doing what, and all those things were there. In 1994, we closed all the vertical projects and come out with the integrated basic health care package or program, and the donor support also. We requested that give us program-based budget, not the project-based budget. But many agreed, but many did not agree. They continue on the project approach, continuing where something like JICA is still there. I think 2013 July, the JICA project was closed. And SDC, Swiss Development Corporation. So they are still there, and then the latest one is the Global Fund. But many of them have switched to the program. And there was a coordination mechanism was still not there. But to the reproductive health and the chef motherhood had some sort of coordination mechanism in early 1996. So in 2002, we evaluated the health services and joint team of by the government of Nepal and the donors, and found health services not coordinated and still following fragmented approach. Something like, though we called it as a program, but the approach was still said that this is a fragmented approach. It has been written in the documents, fragmented approach adopted. So that the donor conference, the Nepal Development Forum, that is hosted every 2 years, and the high level participation is there from the ministers and director generals, from the chief of the aid agencies. Around 100 people gather in Kathmandu, and they suggested that this fragmented approach will carry nowhere to you. So you should start sector-wide approach. And if you start sector-wide approach, we'll try to come out with a budget support package. So in this sense, the World Bank and the DFID were the foremost agencies to come out with the budget support initially, but later on, the Australian government, the German government, Gavi also now has we have an agreement with a budget support. So we had this Nepal Health Sector Program with SWAP framework in 2004, and Nepal became member of the International Health Partnership Plus in 2007. The then British Prime Minister Gordon Brown initiated this International Health Partnership to make some sort of coordination in health at the global level, at the local level, country level. Very good concept. And currently there is a ISP Plus office at the WHO headquarters in Geneva, and it is looking after the system, making a system of a country assessment system. What happens is that when there is a support to the government of Nepal, it's a World Bank support, the World Bank will come with a thick form saying that CPIA or something like that you have to fill up, and it takes many more days to fill that form. And DFID will go for with a fiduciary risk initiative. OSAID will go for the finance to the counter terrorism. So all those things, you see, and with support to the country, and will be busy for months, 2 months, and filling all these forms, and that sort of things was supposed to be replaced by this International Health Partnership Plus initiative. It has come out with the evaluation form, and there is a practice. I believe that it will be approved by all agencies, and in future for health, this will be good for countries, that one tool will be sufficient for all agencies, donor agencies. So I was in 1997, I was in Japan, and make a presentation like this, and presented that the maternal mortality ratio is 1996. After my presentation, one of the participant, not from Japan, he said, oh, you have two Mount Everest. One real Mount Everest, top of the world, and another Mount Everest of maternal deaths. You have to act. So I was very much ashamed, you see. But with changed policies and reforms, the maternal mortality ratio began to decline quickly. If we see that in 2012, the UN estimated indirectly, this is an indirect estimate, that it has come down to 170, and this is fairly high, but in comparison to 539, this is more than 60, two-thirds less. So this is a very big achievement. And so why it happened? There was this SHAPE motherhood program, a national priority program for 20 years, high commitment on GON and donors toward the MDG5 and the SHAPE motherhood. The SHAPE motherhood program was launched by the Prime Minister of Nepal at that time. We trained skilled birth attendants, and we are trying to train 10,000 skilled birth attendants by 2015. We implemented abortion program. We launched this AMA program, is Nepali, and it is mother security program, and everything is free. If somebody is pregnant, if cesarean section free, 50 days in ICU free. So all the cost is taken care by the government of Nepal. Nothing the women has to pay. Did not pay a single penny for safe motherhood services. So we have scaled up. We started a birthing center at the villages also. We did periodical studies, piloting, evaluation of maternal intervention, and we created evidences and tried to implement it. We task shift. The doctors were very angry initially, and some of the tasks of the physician transferred to nurses and the medical auxiliaries, and there was cross-sectoral coordination, like education, women empowerment. As somebody told earlier, that we had 200 women parliamentarians earlier, and that was the largest number in the world. One-third, 35% of the women in the parliament were female, and this was taken as a great women empowerment. And remittance also is a very big source. and probably this has contributed in health also. We don't have evidence. We need to study and establish the linkage between the health and remittance. So if we see that since 2003-04, in 2003-04, the Nepal health budget was just 5.5 billion average rupees. And 2008-09, it went to nearly 15 billion. And currently it is 27 billion. So from 5 billion to 27 billion, that is more than 400 times increment on the budget. This is due to the swap approach also, because the transaction cost has reduced. And the more budget is now available for the program and the services, that is one of the cause. How this budget increased for the health. And coordinated and continuous support to the National Safe Motherhood Program by donors till 2004. There was some sort of coordination started, as I already said. And implementation of health swap in 2004 with both full and earmark funding with focus on health-related MDGs. The focus was not removed, though there was a swap. Swap means budget support. Budget support means government has upper hand. You can put this money in TB program, malaria program, buy CT scans, can build hospitals, and you can undermine the safe motherhood services, child health services. But the government did not do that, and we try to put more money in the MDG interventions, both 4, 5, 6. And we started result-based financing by government and the donors to health sector, offering more achievement, more budget. The initial agreement was that do more, get more. So this sort of understanding was that, and with this understanding, the earlier in the phase one, we finished first 5-year cycle. There was good achievement, and the World Bank said that you have done good achievement, so we'll put additional $50 million. Then DFID said, no, we will not like to give 50 million, but at least 20 to 25 million we want to put it. So there was additional incentive given, and we put more that money in maternal and child health services. And currently, since 2010, there is a result framework in the Nepal Health Sector Program too. And annually, the results framework is discussed, evaluated, and achievements are analyzed. And the TA also, there is a TA, technical assistance. We are trying to have a MOU of the TA also. We are working last 1 year. This is a very big politics. TA, alignment of the TA with government requirement. So maybe in by this December 2012, we'll have a MOU with all the health sector donors and the government of Nepal. So till now, we channelize for the capacity development process. So there is improvement in institution and the governance also. Introduction of social audit and accountability mechanism are in place. We have governance and accountability action plan. The private sector is we are involving if it is needed. The 24-hour birthing facilities in the villages, in the communities, the health facilities have become more functional. People now, if they are sick, usually the village clinics close during night. They only operate in a fixed time during the day only. But with 24-hour delivery services in those clinics, if people become sick, they have acute gastroenteritis or high fever, they can go to the health facilities and can access the health services. More resources channelized to health from community and the local governments also started to give more money and to put more extra staff with this new service delivery mechanism. So the relation is the donors changing towards development partners. We say external development partners. And the this is a big shift, and the attitude, the behavior, had changed towards the development partners. We are moving towards, and very soon, I think, this will be some sort of a partnership between the national government and the donors. Donors using national policies in the system because of the budget support. You are the national financial management system, national procurement system, national audit system has to be followed. Though we need to. We need improvement in these areas because the procurement system, financial management system of the underdeveloped countries is not at international standard. Gradually, they have to be upgraded to the international standard. There is active participation in joint annual reviews and other meetings, and in the joint annual reviews, there is a very high level participation from donor headquarters and UN agencies. Health sector donors formed separate forum and rotate chair every year, and the chair is now one door formal channel of communication. We send the channel. If this is a, this letter has to go to World Bank, we first send to the donor chair. Maybe the donor chair is the WHO, and he will communicate to the World Bank. So we have tried to be one channel. And sometimes this is not agreed, then we say that this is you have formed this donor chair. We did not say that you formed a donor chair, a donor coordination, your internal coordination mechanism. So the future continued support through SWAP framework till maternal health achieves universal coverage and for the decline in maternal deaths and health system is strengthened. Because the if we go for the maternal health, from Mount Everest, it has become a dwarf mountain, and it has further go down. And help government and evidence-informed policy revisions, assist government in improving governance and accountability in the health sector. This is emerging as a big issue throughout the world. Capacity development of the SWAP is a big initiative, and it needs capacity of the Ministry of Health. Otherwise, you cannot continue SWAP for a long term. So a challenge is, we have a long political transition usage. There was a CHI constituent assembly. It could not write the constitution. But the peace building process is near to completion. There was a Maoist group and the Maoist fighters, all of them have now been included inside the Nepal army. They have been integrated, and it is in the final process. Increasing governance issues, procurement and financial management. We have the mountains issue. There is a problem bringing the data from the mountains. If there is a cloud, the internet will not work, the mobile will not work. If it is windy, I have witnessed, I was in the district headquarter of the Mount Everest, we call Solokhumbu. And 3 days we were locked. There is no mobile, there is a continuous wind, and there is no internet, you see. There are challenges. I don't know how to overcome the challenges. Topography is a very big thing, difficult to deliver the services. People are staying in 17,500 feet high. Just beneath the Mount Everest base camp, 500 feet below, there is a big village. And somebody asked me, the Japanese princess asked me, how do you provide service to a woman who is bleeding after delivery just beneath the Mount Everest base camp? Then I said that, Your Majesty, I don't have any answer now. We cannot give any answer. So decreasing donor aid in health sector. You see, the donor aid has decreased. So despite the commitments, it has slightly decreased. And I give example as that we were going together in the Mount Everest. And the fourth camp is the final camp to go in the top of the Mount Everest. If you live on South Goal, it is going to be a problem. And you want to come back, then can you problem? Please continue till 2015. So conclusion, maternal deaths in declined by 2/3. The UN General Assembly gave us award. The average age, average life expectancy went to 68 years. It was just 55 years, 10 years ago. Continuous policies work, and Nepal believes any health aid should be nationally owned, long-term perspective of support. And well coordinated can produce better results and health outcomes, and makes health sector sustainable. The fragmented approach will not be very much sustainable, and rather it will create problem in the future. And many donors are sweating because they established a clinic and there is no money, wanted to close, and people began to go to strike. blocked the road, and they began to sweat, and give a telephone call what to do, and they are blocking the roads. So that sort of things happen, and let's work for sustainable financing of the health in future. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.